Hello everyone. So today I am here for the another aspect covering the drug information services, which is the part number 2. As in the previous lecture, we have discussed about what is DIC, Drug Information Center, and the Poison Information Center. So we have covered the functions of these of the information centers. Today we'll cover what is drug information and what are the different sources of the drug information, from where the information can be taken, and what is the storage and retrieval of information. So let's see with the slide number 1. What is Drug Information Center? So cover with the definition part. Drug Information Center, drug information. So drug information is refers, we are referring here is the current critically examined, because this is the information which deals with the drug. So it should be current, it should be appropriate and critically examined. So every information should be true. Relevant data about drugs, and this is very important because information is everywhere. If we see the there are the sites, there are the web pages, we can search for the drugs, but what is reliable? So for the reliability, for checking the information which is critically examined, which is current, there are some of the options. So see, it can be obtained from various sources, such as national formulary. National formulary is one of the, we can say, the standard source from where we can see we can take the information regarding the drug. Then there is monthly index of medical specialty. This is also one of the information source. Another example is the current index of medical specialty, CIMS, short term as CIMS. So these are some of the information sources used in the hospitals for taking the information, and they all are current, because it is updated time to time. They are critically examined, because very fine research articles, current clinical trials, the information are taken from these type of sources. So it is critically examined and the data is the relevant. So this is all about the drug information, how the drug information should be, and we have discussed some of the examples here. Now on the broad basis, if I will say, on broad basis, I am using the term as broad basis. So on broadly basis, the sources are primary, the sources are secondary, and sources could be tertiary. So information can be taken from the primary source, from the secondary source, and from the tertiary source. Now we'll read what is primary, secondary, and tertiary, and there are some other type of drug information sources also. So point number 1, primary source. Primary source means which is, we can say, research work. So it includes unpublished studies, all these studies which is unpublished and which is original. Okay, so this is important. So all the original work will take as the primary source. So every information we will take from as a primary source, they are taken from the research articles. So research articles are the best example of the primary source. And see, reputed peer reviewed journals, the articles which is published in the reputed peer reviewed journals, but it should be original, reporting original research ideas and opinions. So it should not be the secondary work, it should be the primary work, means the original work. So it consists of clinical research studies. These type of studies, of course, they are original, and it could be both published, it could be both unpublished. So the main important point, that study should be the original form. So journals that publish primary literature includes, there are some of the examples which we call for the internal medicine, clinical pharmacology and therapeutics. So the journals these type of journals which are taking the original research articles, they all come under the primary source. So the information which is taken from the research articles are the best example of the primary source. Similarly, after covering the primary source, we get to know about the secondary source, and as the name mentions, secondary source means all the information which is taken from any second party, we can say. What is second party here is the all the review articles. So all the review articles covered under the secondary source. It refers to the indexing and abstracting systems that organize, provide easy retrieval of the primary source. So in the review articles, what we are doing, we are collecting the information from lot of articles, and then there is a review written, which we call it as a review articles, and these are working as the secondary source. They are also provide easy retrieval, because the whole of the primary literatures are involved for the formation of the secondary source, so they provide the easy retrieval. Some of the example here is the IVR drug information services. They are providing information as a secondary source. Medline is also one of the web source. International pharmaceutical abstracts, they are providing information, all the review articles we can check out from there. Clinalit, PubMed, they are the article source. National Library of Medicine. So these are the sources we can take off as the secondary source. Basically, this is the work done by the second party, means the review articles. Now, next source is the tertiary source. What do we mean by the tertiary source? So it summarizes all the data from the primary source and the secondary source. Primary source means data as original work, and secondary work or secondary source means all the data which is reviewed or done by any other one, means secondary party. So it summarizes data from the primary, I told you, and the secondary literature. So both of the compilation from the primary source as well as the secondary source, whatever the data we will get from the compilation of it, we call it as a tertiary source. So there are some of the examples what come under the tertiary source. There is reference books. Some of the reference book which are taking the information which is original, research articles, information from the clinical trials, and also from the review articles, review information. So reference books, essential drug list, whatever the essential drug list is formed, they also take the information from the primary source as well as secondary sources. Other are the drug bulletins, pharmacopoeias, some of the standard treatment guidelines for particular disease. There are the formulary services, some are the examples such as Metrendil, the complete drug reference book, Remington Pharmaceuticals. So basically books are the best examples which take the compilation of both of the data, primary as well as the secondary source. Now I told you on the broad basis the sources are categorized as a primary, secondary and tertiary. There are some other sources such as electronic bulletin board. So this type of source is they all are giving the information, and the most important purpose which I can identify from this is they actually are aware the people. So electronic bulletin board, they basically are aware the people, as we are dealing with the healthcare system. So of course they are aware the patients, laymen, common people, about a disease, about the treatment strategies. So electronic bulletin boards, they are the local bulletin boards which are posted through a server. As the name mentioned, they are electronic. So with the help of computer and modem they are working. What we try to attain here is from the electronic bulletin board is they increasingly turning to billboard advertising to promote various health services. As here we can see, it is telling about the COVID-19 situation. So there are other electronic bulletin boards which are basically used for the awareness of the patients or laymen. Now other sources of information we can see there some of the national web pages are also there. So from these web pages information regarding the drug or a therapy can be taken, and professionals, healthcare professionals, the common people, they are taking the information from the national web pages. Government organization and pharmaceutical manufacturers, they also are taking information. The ability to use the quality of information obtained from the web is increasing important. So I told you there are some of the reliable web pages. What are these reliable web pages? We'll discuss in the later slides. Now, internet web sources. So what are these internet web sources? See, in the previous slides I also discussed what are the web sources. These are some of the examples of the sites like www.whoint. So this is giving the information about the drug, about the diseases. We can search, we can study about the disease demography, the treatment strategies, and the every aspects of a particular disease. There is another example called as Australian Prescriber. For this, the site is http://www.australianprescriber.com. Similarly, there are others also. So we can see these are the web pages which are reliable and used for the drug information. Now, so as we are covering the information sources as web source, computerized source, what are these softwares? We'll discuss here in the slides. There are some of the softwares and there are different web pages for it. Let's see an example here. Access Medicine. This is one of the software. So in this we can see some of the books like Harrison online. So Harrison book is online present in the Access Medicine. We can study this book. This is the therapeutics book, Goodman and Gilman. Pharmacology, current medical diagnosis and treatment. These are some of the examples of book which is very freely available in the Access Medicine. Now there is another Cochrane Library. Cochrane Library, now this is the second example, and from the Cochrane Library, because every type is different from their own perspective, so Cochrane Library is giving the information regarding the clinical trials. So information regarding the clinical trials for any of the new drug and for any of the new indication can be taken from the this Cochrane Library. Then there is a Micromedics. This is also one of the web source. Micromedics, every information regarding a drug, it is there. Means data which support the clinical care decision. So for the physician, it is very beneficial to take information from the Micromedics. Other examples are also there. One is Natural Medicine. So every information regarding the natural source, means the herbal drugs, we can get from the Natural Medicine. This is also one of the web source. Similarly, PMC, PubMed. PMC is the PubMed Central, which is free full text archive. Yahan pe aapko sar collection milega, every articles regarding the biomedical. What is the specificity? We can see biomedical life sciences. So articles regarding the biomedical life sciences, these all we can get from the PubMed Central. Another is PubMed. So the articles regarding the health, medicine, nursing, biology, so these type of web sources can be taken as a support while taking information about the drug. Another example, Scopus. So this is basically, there we can get the, this is one of the journal. So here we can get the articles, both type, published, review, research and research, review both. Both type of articles can be taken from this Scopus. and they are dealing with every departments we can see. Science is there, technology related articles, medicine related department, social sciences related, art and humanities. Now ToxNet is also there. ToxNet is also one of the web source where the information regarding the poisons, it's dealing with the toxicology. So information regarding the poison can be taken from this ToxNet. There is a Lexicom. This is also one of the web source. And the information related, like patient education, drug calculators, how to calculate the drugs, toxicology, which is poisonous in nature, how much drug amount is poisonous, IV compatibility. So these type of specific areas are covered in the Lexicom. So we have covered what are the examples in the computerized services as a drug information sources. In the previous slide, I told you there are some databases and the some of the web addresses. Like example, I can see one is Medscape. So for the Medscape, we can see what is the web address: HTTP www.medscape.com. Similarly, this is one of the very popular. Now Drug Information Center, we can see here www.mspcinindia.org/dic/home. So like this, we can see for different of the databases, there are different of the web addresses which can be followed for the drug information. Now coming to the point of the storage and retrieval of data. In the previous section, we have discussed what is drug information and from where the information can be taken. So broad basis, there are the three types: primary, secondary and tertiary. The other sources are also there, which we call as the web sources or electronic billboard. Now we'll cover the storage and retrieval, how to retrieve the data, how to store the data. So definition, what do you mean by the storage and retrieval of data? See, the systematic process of collecting, as we are talking about the storage, what we'll do, we'll collect. So systematic process, this is a process where we are collecting and cataloging data so that it can be located and displayed on request. This is called as retrieval. On giving a request, a particular file will open. So this is called as retrieval. How will retrieve the data? Now computers and data processing techniques are used. Basically the computer processing systems are used for the storage and retrieval of data because the information is in lot. So on a single request, we want the file to open. Computers and data processing techniques have made possible the high speed, I told you, because these are some of the advantages of the computer systems. So they are giving the high speed selective retrieval. Just on giving a particular keyword, the file will open. So selective retrieval of a large amounts of information for, of course, whosoever want the information. It could be government, commercial, economic purpose. Commercial means any industry, any manufacturing industry could be there. Now there are some of the examples of information storage and retrieval system. So there are basically three types. What are these three types? See, document retrieval system. Another type is the database system. And last one is the reference retrieval system. So what happens in this system? We'll discuss one by one. Point number one, document retrieval system. What we'll do here is the data is retrieved by giving the keywords. Yes? So any keywords, like if we want the information about a particular drug A, which is used in the disease of we can say schizophrenia. So our keyword could be schizophrenia or treatment of schizophrenia, any such 2-3 words we can take, or any title. By these of the titles, the file will open, the related documents will open. So in the document retrieval system, they store entire documents which are usually retrieved. So what is the input here? We'll use the title or keywords for retrieving the data. Point number two, database system. How database systems are working? These systems are working, here the data is retrieved by giving the inputs which is present in the files. So we can give the name such as name, address. We can give input as address. We can write phone number. By this the file will open. So it is written in the slide here, database systems store the information as a series of discrete records. So here the information is stored as a discrete record. And what are these discrete records? So these discrete records could be by the name, by the address, by the phone number, or any other fields. So when they are giving the input as a name, address, or phone number, the file will open. So records can be searched and retrieved on the basis of content of the fields. So I told you, this type of system means the database system, they are working on the series of discrete records. Now the point number three, reference retrieval systems. In the reference retrieval systems, what happened here? The file will open means by the file, I just want to say the file means whatever the document we want to read for our query. Yes? And query could be about any drug, any disease, any treatment strategy, any management, any adverse drug reaction, or any of the aspect of drug. So in the reference retrieval system, what is there? As the name mentions, stored references. So they are storing the references. When they are giving input as references, of course, it will open the document. So reference retrieval system store references to documents rather than the document themselves. So these are the basic difference of the systems which are used for the storage and the retrieval of the data. Now in whole of the slides, we have discussed about the drug information services, and this is the another aspect of the drug information services. As in the previous lectures, we have discussed what is drug information center, what is poison information center. Here we discussed another aspect, that what is drug information and how the information can be taken. And why it is important? Because the reliability is very important. We have to take the data which is current, which is unbiased, and which is, we can say, the accurate. So for the accuracy, it is very important to know what could be the sources which are reliable there. So there are the web sources we have discussed. We have discussed the sources on the broader basis, primary, secondary, and tertiary. And what is the storage and retrieval system and the types. I hope you got about all these things, and for this, thank you so much. We'll meet in the next session for the next lecture.